Bismillah wa alhamdulillah wa sallallahu wa sallam ala rasulillah wa alihi wa sahbihi wa man wala. Assalamu alaikum.
Assalamu alaikum.
We're here today, we're dealing with everything Usool al-Fiqh. We are in the 3,000 line poem. We're on verse number 11. This is still part of the introduction. So he begins, he says, وَكُنْتُ عَازِمًا عَلَىٰ نَظْمِ لَهَا مُقَرِّبًا لِلظَّامِئِينَ جُلَّهَا فَبَيْنَمَا رِجْلِي لِذَا أُقَدِّمُ مُؤَخِّرًا أُخْرَى لِكَيْ مَا تُحْجِمُ جَاءً شَخْصٌ آخِذٌ رِسَالَةً قَدْ احْتَوَتْ مَا قَدْ ذَكَرْتُ حَالَةً. So let's go through this so we can understand what he's saying here, okay? Because we began the poem and now we're getting into the meat of the introduction, okay? And in this introduction, he's explaining how he came about to write a poem on Usool al-Fiqh. And it's interesting because it's the same thing that I told you I was going through, the same issue. And this expresses it clearly. He says, وَكُنْتُ, and I was, عَازِمًا, a قَاسِدًا بِقُوَّةً, meaning I had a strong intention to do, determination to do something, عَزَمْتُ, right? كُنْتُ عَازِمًا, I was determined, عَلَى نَظْمِ, to write a nazm, a poem, لَهَا, about Usool al-Fiqh. I learned best when reading poetry in this way, and this is coming from that rap culture, how we, and that poetic culture that we come, that even predates the Islam. We always learn through rhymes. Even in Western culture, we have what they call nursery rhymes to teach things. So I was benefiting from learning poetry when I went to Mauritania, and now with learning all these other poems, I learned that all the sciences in Islam are written in poetic form. So I said, hey, I'm going to write a poem on Usool al-Fiqh for the Westerners, okay? And the Sheikh said he was feeling the same thing. كُنْتُ عَازِمًا عَلَىٰ نَظْمِ لَهَا, writing a poem on Usool al-Fiqh. مُقَرِّبًا, making the poem a means to bring people closer, understand it better, okay? So the poem is just the outline, okay? And the lessons in between fill up the blanks in there, okay? So the nazm is not the end result, it's just what we use to keep the order, sequential order of how we're supposed to understand the table of contents. And by using the poem, you rely on the poem to remind you what comes next, okay? And that's the purpose of the poetry. He says, so that he says, muqarriban, to bring the people closer to understanding. What? لِلظَّامِئِينَ جُلَّهَا. الظَّامِئِينَ is عَاطِشِينَ. The one who is dhama'an is the person, we say, what do we say when in Ramadan? Dhahaba dhama'u, the thirst has gone away when we break our fast, right? Dhama'an is the one who is thirsty, okay? So, dhami'in, what it means, those who are desirous. And thirst is an expression to show a strong desire for something, especially in the Islamic Arabic desert culture where needing water, you die. The Sharia is called the path, is literally the path to the watering hole, okay? Showing the place of water in our life. So someone thirsting means someone who wants something. Someone is desiring for something, okay? So it says, making it close for those who really want it, who are thirsty and desirous to learn about Usool al-Fiqh. Jullaha. So the poem is going to be on Jullaha, on most of it, Mu'adhamuha. Why only Jullaha? Because we're not going to make poetic lines about the hadith and the Qur'an, the ayat of Qur'an. There are certain things you cannot put into poetry, okay? So here, that's what we're saying, most of it. The qawa'id, the principles. And even then, we're putting words together to help you remember what the principle is, okay? So it says, so most of it. فَبَيْنَمَا رِجْلِ لِذَا أُقَدِّمُ. And so while I was putting my foot forward, رِجْلِ is my leg, my foot forward, أُقَدِّمُ, to go do that, مُؤَخِّرًا, putting the other one was staying back, أُخْرَ, meaning the other foot, لِكَيْ مَا تُحْجِمُ. I was hesitant, he was between two things. And this is the situation I found myself in for literally years. Okay? One foot forward, I want to do this. I see the importance to this. Why? Because we see how many of the Salaf, the people of the past, how much attention this is given by the scholars. Imam Sa'adi, look at just in our era, Ibn Uthaymeen, how much attention he put forward Usool al-Fiqh. He even himself wrote a poem about the issue. Okay? So I was like that, but then, for the same reason the Sheikh said, my other foot was remaining back. I was hesitant in doing it. Why? Hey, button, out of respect for the science, number one, it's very technical, number two, and how few people show and actually desire nowadays for it. How few people are actually ready to take this lesson. You know, we say, oh, I want to learn. And then, gharik, when we sleep through the lessons, we don't have the stomach for it like we're supposed to have. This is very important. This is the science that helps you think the way Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala intended you to think. How to understand the ayat, how to understand the sharia, and understand the ahadith in the sharia, and how to apply those things. It's very important, okay? However, we don't find many people doing it, so we're hesitant. We're between these two roads for many years. So he says, فَبَيْنَمَا while I'm my foot forward, wanting to do it, and my other foot back, holding back, not going forward, refraining. جَاءً شَخْصٌ أَخِذٌ رِسَالَةً Here comes this young man. He's not a young man, he's my age. Here comes a person, this is the Shaykh speaking. Someone came, أَخِذٌ رِسَالَةً who took the risala. قَدْ احْتَوَتْ مَا قَدْ ذَكَرْتُ حَالَةً He said, and he احْتَوَتْ إِحْوَى أَجْمَى He gathered together, he compiled and organized based on everything that I was thinking about. He wrote and authored a book, ذَكَرْتُ Everything that I mentioned was a situation he mentioned in his book. And he's mentioning, this is Muhammad ibn Hussein al-Jizani. This is a sheikh. He got his his PhD, writing a book about how the Risala is the book that we can use to explain Usul al-Fiqh according to ahlus sunnah wal jama'ah. Okay? And he wrote another about that. So the Shaykh said, here goes this young person, he wrote a book about this thing for his PhD in arguing this particular thing. So he was happy about that particular situation. And that was what pushed him to say, you know what? Here, the young, out of the mouths of babes, it's not young to us. Okay, like I said, but according to the Sheikh, this young man come to it, I'm gonna go ahead and do it. And we see that happens a lot of time. The youth push forward and remind the elders that this is what they're supposed to do. This is how we have to go ahead and do it. Walau. What does walau mean? Even though some of the people may not be ready for it, but we get them ready. Now we have to charge ourselves to present it in a way to make the people easier to get it. And that's what we're trying to do here, is present it in a way that more people can get it. That's why we're making the lessons short. Since people get bored quickly, we make them short, inshallah ta'ala, to benefit. And we'll talk about that more later on. So let's go through the lines. وَكُنْتُ عَازِمًا عَلَى نَظْمِي لَهَا
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 مقربا للظالمين جلها
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 not ظالمين الظالمين say that وكنت عازما على نظمي لها
وكنت عازما على نظمي لها
مقربا للظالمين جلها
مقربا للظالمين جلها
فبينما رجلي لذا أقدم
بينما رجلي لذا أقدم
فبينما رجلي لذا أقدم
فبينما رجلي لذا أقدم
فبينما رجلي لذا أقدم لكي ما تحجم
مؤخرا أخرى 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 لكي ما تحجم
فبينما رجلي لذا أقدم
فبينما رجلي لذا أقدم
مؤخرا أخرى لكي ما تحجم
مؤخرا أخرى لكي ما تحجم
جاء شخص آخذ الرسالة
جاء شخص آخذ الرسالة
قد احتوت ما قد ذكرت حالة
قد احتوت ما قد ذكرت حالة.
We're gonna stop here. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم والسلام عليكم.
وعليكم السلام.